What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and yes, today is all about installing Linux GSM on Ubuntu, so let's get right into it. Okay, so what is Linux GSM? I looked this up. It interests me. I started playing around with it, but the problem is that I did not complete it, and hopefully you guys are able to complete it for me. I just did not have the hardware to actually successfully get this up and running because your host of where you're going to install this machine needs to have a good GPU, good CPU, a lot of memory, right? Because you're going to be hosting a gaming server. That's what it is. So what is Linux GSM? It stands for Linux Game Server Manager. Yes, server. That's why I liked it. So it's a powerful command line tool designed to simplify the management of game servers on Linux operating system. It offers a comprehensive set of features that streamline the installation, configuration, maintenance, and various game servers, making it a popular choice for server administrators and gaming fans. That's why it kind of interests me. Like, yeah, a game server manager, that's so pretty cool. But like I said before, the machine that you're going to be installing this into has to be really beefy. It has to have a lot of memory, a good GPU card, you know. And I did everything within a virtual environment, within my VMware workstation. It's not really best practice, right? But I just wanted to see how everything, like the installation process will go. So within my Ubuntu machine, I open up my terminal. First command that we need to do is the following. Got to make sure that you push out every update and upgrade on your machine. I did a sudo apt-get update and upgrade and hit enter. It's going to ask for my password. So I enter my password, hit enter, and it's going to start processing and upgrading and pushing out all the updates. Now, this machine was already patched up, so I did not have any updates or upgrade. Now, the next command that we need to run is the following. We need to do a sudo apt-get install wget tar bzip2 gzip unzip python 3 bin utilities bc and then tmux. Those are the utilities that we need to install to get this up and running. So I'm going to hit enter. Boom, it's going to start processing, you know, downloading whatever, and it's going to ask, do you want to continue? Click Y for yes and hit enter, and then boom, you're done. Now we're going to run the following command to grab a copy of the linuxgsm.sh shell script. Hit enter. Boom, it downloaded it. Awesome. Next command that we're going to run is the following. We're going to change the permissions on that shell file, and we're going to hit enter. Now it didn't work out for me because I did not have curl installed. So to get curl installed, we are going to run the following command. Awesome. Hit enter and installed. Let's rerun that command again. We're going to change the permissions and hit enter. Bam, the permissions was changed within that shell script that we downloaded. Awesome. Next command that we need to run is the following. Well, I ran this command because I wanted to get Counter-Strike pulled down to this machine. Again, not really best practice. I'm doing everything inside a virtual machine. It is best that you do it on a physical machine with the hardware to support this particular game. So I hit enter. So running the command, it actually installed the Counter-Strike Global Offensive server as the CSGO server. It actually gives you a command to continue the installation. So we're going to type that in. We're going to hit enter. You're going to get this, which is great. It wants me to continue. So I'm going to hit Y and hit enter. It's going to start installing everything that it needs to do. You're going to see all the progress. It's pulling down the server locally to the machine. Eventually, you're going to get the following. Was the install successful? It was. I didn't receive any errors. So hit Y. Hit enter, boom. Once you hit enter, it's going to give you this. It needs to get a token. This is where I stopped, and hopefully if you guys have a machine that is capable of handling Counter-Strike to run properly, because I'm doing everything within a virtual machine, it's really silly to do this, but I just wanted to see how the process and all the steps go. We need to get a token. Now, to get a token, there's documentation online that takes you to this particular site to retrieve a token within your account. You need to log in and generate a token, and then go back into the command prompt and then paste the token and then continue the installation. I didn't do that because I feel like me installing Counter-Strike on this small little virtual machine, it's not going to run, and it's just so silly. So that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.